老师，把我们声音大一点。读书还做饭，我也喜欢学习，不同的语言，学也是汉语。虽然汉语太难，但老师教说，怕他能，他就能，不能也能，不怕难，就能。那你不能加油？好，最重要的是加油。好的，那我们先来自我介绍一下，我来自乌克兰的李娜。 其实从小我对中国的文化非常感兴趣，没想到我以后真的很有机会去中国留学。2008年不远万里，我从美丽的乌克兰来到了美丽的武汉，在华中师范大学，我开始我学习的汉语旅途。2015年我毕业于武汉大学，拿到博士学位之后呢，我回到了自己的老家乌克兰，然后开始。 教我们的学生、孩子们，还有大人汉语。这里背后的你们可以看到一些我在中国的照片，还有在乌克兰的一些我学习汉语的小学生。我们不只希望学生能说好汉语，但是一定要好好了解中国文化。虽然汉语很难，但是我相信。 通过我们的努力，我们老师们的一些功夫，我们的学生会跟我一样喜欢中国，爱上中国。因为我个人非常希望更多的人会更好了解中国。好，这里一些我们的学生，但是我接下来向我的同事介绍一下，谭慧琳老师也是我以前的学生，现在也是我的同事，请。 好的，那今天的我们准备的节目是大约跟大家讲一讲我们在乌克兰，主要是乌克兰的西部学习汉语的情况。大家知道现实，知道我们现在的情况，所以说，可能不是那种我们希望的那样，但是算是还行。我们老师们不管在什么情况下都要坚持，都要给我们的学生很好的教育。所以今天先讲一讲我们。 戈尔巴迁国立大学和里沃夫国立大学教育情况。开始之前，这里不得不提到一个乌克兰非常有名的组织，非常大的，这个是汉学家协会，这个是我们乌克兰全国最大的，其实也是唯一一个协会。我是也是这个协会的成员。 我们的任务主要的是，不只是翻译，尤其是最近我们翻译成了很多信息，传播传到就是乌克兰中国，因为希望更多的中国朋友们知道真正的消息呢。那我们的这个汉学家协会也有自己的期刊呢，你们也欢迎投稿，这里有英文、汉语和乌克兰文。 在这个汉学家协会也有乌克兰的信息呢，也有中文的乌克兰新闻报道。除此之外呢，我想跟大家今天分享一下我们最近一些我的同事们做的一首歌，我们翻译成汉语，请大家欣赏。
家被摧毁，心已破碎，他在攻击，我无法放弃。
炮声伴随落在地的喧哗，而敌人仍在说话。
让春天来吧，站在一起我们不害怕，
就算被残忍的屠杀，心里怀着永恒的希望。
那接下来我们要看一下我们的大学的情况。首先我讲一讲利物浦国立大学，我在这里也教课，虽然只有一周一次，但是呢，我想大家知道利物浦国立大学是我们全国最古老的一所大学，1661年建的，然后1817年有中文系。在这里很可惜没有太多本土老师，只有志愿者还有我呢，所以说可能搞的活动并不多，而且我的家乡离利物浦有130公里，现在只能线上上课呢，但是学生挺用功的。然后值得的提出这所大学跟基辅国立大学合作，孙科文老师还有别的老师们挺支持 这所大学。然后最近他们搞的一种活动，全国翻译比赛，然后利物浦国立大学的一个学生，也是我的学生尤里，他得了奖，然后拿到了去武汉大学的机会，因为这个比赛是由武汉大学和我们汉学家协会主办的。那下一个是我们讲一讲关于我们现在所住的也是工作的地方，叫戈尔巴钦国立大学，这是大院的介绍，看一下。对，这是我们的母校，也是现在我们所工作的地方。我们大学，我得说，我们的校长非常支持我们推广汉语。虽然汉语暂时只是我们，第二外语，没有汉语系，但是我们往这个方向努力。我们的戈尔巴钦国立大学作为了教学点，2018年。基辅国立语言大学的孔子学院的院长，石老师来到我们大学，然后我们签了合同，从此以后很多志愿者来到我们的大学，也帮助我们教学生上课。我们推广了汉语，不只是在大学，很多小朋友们也进入了我们这个学习汉语的经验呢。然后呢， 其实每年都有志愿者来我们大学挺好的，但是以后有疫情了，所以就没办法了，现在只能线上上课了。所以这里可以提出一些缺点，就是不足的方面，我和丹慧丽老师要主要是讲一讲。第一个就是我们觉得学校安排的课程真的很少，可能这个是因为他们的第一外语是英语，汉语是第二外语。第二呢，刚开始大家我们觉得所有的学生学习非常积极，但是一到大三大四的时候，他们的这个积极性越来 越低了。然后不知道别的国家是不是也是同样的情况，希望有人跟我们分享一下。第三呢，我们觉得，我个人也觉得没有统一的一个教材，就是我们每个大学的老师有用什么教材就用什么教材，我还是觉得 这方面也不是挺好的。第四呢，没有乌克兰语的好教材，对，有当代中文，但是里面的乌克兰语的字母就是错误特别的多，然后学生总是一看就笑，所以我们才不用了。所以希望我们在这方面也要努力一下。第五呢，就是对本地韩语老师真的没有任何一个培训呢，而且我们都非常希望能提高自己的汉语水平。所以下一个我们的小愿望就是如下。第一呢，就是不只是大学生，也有小朋友们，还有不同年龄的成年人想学习汉语，因此我个人开了一个培训班，用自己的个人的时间来教，但是说实话真的太难了，有两所大学，有小朋友们呢，所以我希望有一些中国朋友们能过来跟我一起合作，好好推广汉语。第二呢，希望我们的学生学习汉语者能够有机会学习更多不同的中国文化，这要是一些跳舞、唱歌、中国的乐器、书法、太极等等。第三呢，汉语教学大纲一统一的，全乌克兰共同使用的。第四呢，加强各个方面的汉语交流和支持，希望就是我们可以跟不同的国家的一些大学合作，我们的学生或者是可以参加什么讨论会呀之类的活动，我觉得对他们的积极性还有对他们的更加努力会有帮助呢。下一个是可以增加一些课程，那这个可能如果有汉语系就会好的。下一个是学生能够去中国的留学机会，这个对我们的学生来说现在要求太高了，毕竟是第二外语，到大四的时候，他们到五的时候差不多研究生的时候可以得到 HSK4， 但是去中国只能又开始读本科，所以说还是这方面也得希望 能有更好的一些办法。然后最后一个，我们大学非常希望能建立一个孔子学院，或者是至少有一个汉语与中国文化的中心，能够更多的我们西部的人、乌克兰的人了解中国。那下面这些是我讲的是我们老师的一些看法呢。那当然了，我们来之前也请我们的同学们分享一下他们的经验呢，他们的想法，所以我的同事会分享一下，还是同学们的，从同学们的角度来看学习汉语的情况。
好，学生用英语，所以我也说英语。好，用 this。Students' experience of Chinese education. They have three points: experience of learning Chinese, advantages and disadvantages, and also ideas for Chinese education, online and offline. So here we have like. A lot of students took part in this presentation, so they gave their sincere opinion about learning Chinese in our university. So I will read the most interesting ones for you. This is the group. Okay, I think this one. My journey of learning Chinese have started 4 years ago. Chinese is my second language in university. I can say that our teacher pay a lot of attention to our studying and our level of Chinese is growing. I enjoy the process of learning Chinese as far as I like Asian culture. I would like to say that that it's very difficult to learn Chinese, but very exciting. I've noticed that Chinese learning helped me to improve my memory, and I'm very happy that I have opportunity to learn this language. Oh, we have so much of them. I think this one is as well. As for me, I believe that studying Chinese will be beneficial for my future. Speaking foreign languages can contribute to your career growth, help you communicate with foreigners. Actually, I decided to study Chinese as the second foreign language, as it's one of the most widespread languages in the world. And studying Oriental languages is exciting. It develops such essential skills as concentration and memory. Moreover, there is a well-known proverb that claims, as many languages you know, so many times you are a human being. And I totally agree with it. So many of them. Okay, I think Oksana Siashan ye koyi. To tell the truth, the choice of learning Chinese I made spontaneous. When I was entering the university. At that time, I was strongly convinced that studying German or French is quite boring. I had a desire to experience something extraordinary. That's why I gave it a chance. Some time later, I realized that it's an exclusive opportunity to get acquainted with Asian culture. Moreover, knowing Chinese is beneficial for future career. Also, we have here like a small summary. They have a lot of in common, so they did this about their motivation for studying Chinese. So mainly it's a great career opportunity, the desire to learn a unique language, interest in Asian culture, the desire for challenges, the opportunity to communicate with native speakers, the opportunity for developing memory. So this is the main one. Also, what they see as advantages and disadvantages. This is really interesting. Career opportunity. Knowing Chinese, you can negotiate trade deals and important business matters. What's the disadvantage is learning Chinese take a bit amount of time because of writing character, learning words with tones, etc. Discovering Chinese culture. Our teacher tell us a lot about Chinese customs, tradition, and differences between our lifestyles. But due to different circumstances, such as pandemic and war, we cannot go to China. Our teachers do their best to keep us motivated and always keep up with different ideas to make our lesson more interesting. Chinese is one of the most difficult languages in the world. For example, it's very hard to learn Chinese character and proper pronunciation. A lesson with native speakers. When learning Chinese, there is a unique opportunity to have lesson with native speakers. It definitely helps to improve your Chinese level. But due to the difference in culture, it's sometimes difficult to understand Chinese teachers. And also their ideas for online and offline classes. As for offline classes, each of us loves learning directly in the classroom. This is a cool cooperation with the teacher. The possibility of live communication and various activities that are possible only offline. In our opinion, improvisational dialogues are a very cool way of developing communication. They develop the skill of speaking, listening, and quick decision making, which are very important for future translators. To learn new words, you can apply so-called competition on the speed and correctness of writing characters. A cool addition to learning Chinese in the study of Chinese tradition and culture, not only theoretical, but also in practice. Students and teachers can organize various celebrations and workshops to attract more people to studying Chinese language and culture heritage. And also for both online and offline classes, it could encourage students to participate in various Chinese competition. Young people like when they receive awards for their work, and this is.
Yeah, they were participating in the written competition, which was held in Kyiv University. And actually they got first, second, and third prizes, and I was really very happy about that. And actually they also had an opportunity to go to China for 2 weeks before the pandemic, and when they came back, they say they were like second-year students. They were not learning Chinese for a long time, and they were saying like, Lina 老师,我们都听懂了,他们听懂我说话了,非常非常高兴. So I think it's also a very good opportunity for them to communicate, to try themselves, and it gives them more motivation.
Also give students tasks that require group work. This type of work has many advantages. Teachers' cooperation in team allow you to combine different views on the same problem and learn from each other's experience. Provide a good mood because studying with friends is fun. And for online classes, in their opinion, a good idea for online learning is to start the lesson with one interesting fact about China. For example, some kind of holiday, custom, or tradition that's particular for China only. And an interesting task would be to analyze a short Chinese article, translate it, and learn interesting words from it.
But it's not the end. We still have several minutes, I guess we've got. You know, every time before pandemic, we had, I've already mentioned, the Chinese volunteers, and it was very interesting because we could do something more in learning Chinese, and we would like to show you video. We made some classes online. So these are online classes we made with one of my volunteers, Tifeng Guoxiao, and Diana Laoshi. She was an operator. She took her phone. We had a camera, and we made some. Yeah, it was like 10 or more classes, and then she had to go back. I also think it's a very good idea to popularize and Fei Guan Han Yu for your country. And talking about Chinese, we also have very, very young Chinese teacher in Ukraine, in the western part. Her name is Gao Nicole, and she's got already more than 90 videos, and she's teaching Chinese online. She's got her blog, and this is her cousin, Artem, and now they're making like together. She was 5 when she started this blog, and actually a lot of news, like a lot of TV programs, they came to interview her. 这个小朋友就是在我们乌克兰西部当做一个小明星，他推广中文，然后他每一节课就是教一些一句话，比如说这一次他要教的什么，我们待一会儿看看。但是他主要是用乌克兰语，然后教自己的表哥汉语，然后也希望更多的人也能一句一句学汉语。那我们简单的看一下，好吗？
Друзі, бодяніколь,
ніхау, бодяу, Артем.
Ми з вами знову продовжуємо вчити китайську мову.
У нас сьогодні особливий випуск.
Я тебе люблю. Китайською це буде вуайні, вуайні. Я тебе люблю. Артемчик, повтори.
Вуайні, вуайні.
Во-ай-ні, Артемчик, во-ай-ай-ай, во-ай-ні,
во-ай-ні.
Молодець, Артемчик!
Okay, so this is the way every time they shoot this program, and actually they got already a lot of fans. I also think if you got little kids, you can also ask them to teach in this way. A lot of people, not only children, but a lot of adults, they gave a feedback that they are watching and learning Chinese with us. Thank you very much. 谢谢大家. 谢谢大家.